are you today? I hope you are fine. On this topic, we are going to talk about self. We will introduce ourselves to someone else. But before we start our lesson, please prepare your book. We are going to use this book. This is English book from Kementerian Pendidikan dan Kebudayaan Republik Indonesia. And after you prepare your book, please open the book page 4. Well, on this book, page 4, you will see a letter from someone. This is a letter from Hannah. Now, let's listen to this audio because we are going to read this text. Pay attention to your book and listen to the audio here.
Hello, Alia. Let me introduce myself. My name is Hannah. I know your name from my friend, Caroline. She told me that you sent her an email telling her that you would like to have more pen pals from the US. I'd really like to be your e-pal. You sound really cool. I guess I'd better tell you something about myself first. I'm 16 years old and I attend Thomas Edison High School here in Minneapolis, Minnesota, USA. I have two brothers and two half-sisters and I'm the middle child. My father died a few years ago, so my mother runs the house and the family business. My father was a barista. I have lots of hobbies. I like music, mostly classical music and folk music, but I don't play an instrument. I like sports, especially tennis and basketball. At school, I'm in the basketball team, and I spend most of my extracurricular time playing basketball. I'm into animals very much. My sister and I have three dogs. They need lots of attention, as you can imagine. My favorite subjects at school are art and geography. I think I'd like to become a park ranger when I graduate, perhaps work for the National Park Service. I don't like reading, but I love drawing and painting. How about you? Please drop me a line, Alia. Can't wait to hear from you.
Okay, students, you have read about the text. Now, let's discuss the text together. First, look at the first paragraph. You will see the bold type of letter. And let's see the first word. This is pen pals. Do you know what is the meaning of pen pals? Pen pals means sahabat pena in Indonesian language. And then the next one we
You sounds really cool. You sounds really cool
means kamu tampaknya keren ya. Seperti itu ya. Kamu tampak keren. Seperti itu. Nah, on this paragraph, Hannah is introducing herself. She also told Alia that she got her name from her friend. Her name is Caroline, right? Jadi si Hannah tahu tentang Alia melalui temannya yang bernama Caroline. And after that, what else? Hannah told that she wants to be Alia's pen pals. Yang mana Hannah pengen banget nih jadi teman sahabat pena ya. Sahabat penanya si Alia. Nah, let's see the second paragraph. On this paragraph, you may see that Hannah is telling about herself more. Dia menceritakan her family. She told to Alia that she has two brothers and two half-sisters. Kamu tahu half-sisters itu apa? Half-sisters itu adalah saudara tiri. Jadi mereka seibu atau seayah. Seperti itu ya. And then, Hannah also said that she is a middle child. A middle child berarti dia anak tengah. So, she has two brothers and two sisters, ya. Yeah? Two half-sisters. Jadi, she is in the middle. These are brothers, these are sisters, and she is in the middle. Right? Next, Hannah also told Alia that her father has passed away. Berarti ayahnya sudah meninggal. Therefore, her mom mom runs the family and the business. Runs itu maksudnya adalah menjalankan atau melaksanakan, seperti itu ya. She runs the business, berarti dia yang menjalankan bisnis keluarga. Now let's talk about the third paragraph. On this paragraph, Hannah told about her hobbies. There are a lot of hobbies. The first one is listening to music, right? But she cannot play instruments. Maksudnya adalah dia suka musik, tapi dia tidak bisa bermain alat musik. Seperti itu ya. Next, she also likes sport. Dia suka main basketball and she is in the basketball team and she also likes tennis. Nah, Hannah juga bilang, I'm into animals very much. Into means that sangat menyukai, sangat mendalami, sama menyukai lah. For example, dia pecinta hewan. Jadi dia bilang, I'm into animals very much. Seperti itu ya. And guess what? She has 3 dogs. Dia punya 3 anjing. After that, Hannah also tells about her favorite subject at school. She likes art. And then she also likes geography. In the last sentence of the third paragraph, Hannah tells that dia ingin jadi apa in the future. Dia bilang, maybe someday dia mau bekerja di National Park Service. So, in the third paragraph, Hannah tells about her hobbies, yeah, her favorite pets, and also her dreams in the future. Okay, in the last paragraph, Hannah memberitahukan kesukaannya dan yang tidak disukainya. Yang dia tidak sukai adalah reading. She doesn't like reading. But dia suka painting and drawing. Dia suka menggambar dan juga melukis, seperti itu. So, in the last paragraph, dia closing dengan ini. And also, dia bilang dia tidak sabar untuk menanti jawaban dari Alia. Itu cara mengclosing letternya. So, that's the explanation about the letters. Now, read again the text and please make sure that you have understood about the letter. Nah, setelah kita membahas per paragraph, now we are going to discuss about the language features in this text. Jadi, tata bahasa apa sih yang digunakan dalam teks ini? Mostly this text using present tense. Simple present tense. Seperti itu ya. Di sini juga kalian bisa melihat subjective pronouns. For example, I. I contoh dari subjective pronouns. Nah, di sini adalah tabelnya. Ada I, you, they, we, she, he, it. Lalu di sini juga example-nya kita bisa buat ya. For example, I know you from my friend Caroline. Nah, selanjutnya terdapat juga objective pronouns. Jadi, seperti contoh seperti ini ya. Nih, ini ada tabelnya. Yang pertama adalah subjective pronouns, I, you, they, we, she, he, it, yang berperan sebagai subjek. Lalu ada yang berperan sebagai objek, disebut juga dengan objective pronoun. Jadi, contohnya seperti ini. I love you. I berperan sebagai subjek, ya. Dan you di sini berperan sebagai objek. Saya menyayangi kamu. Kamu adalah sebuah objeknya, seperti itu. Selanjutnya, ada yang disebut dengan possessive adjective. Apa itu possessive adjective? Jadi, itu menyatakan kepemilikan. For example, my sister is a midwife. Jadi, saudara perempuan saya adalah seorang bidan. Seperti itu, my sister, saudara perempuan saya. Jadi, kalau misalnya mau ngomongin rumah dia, dianya perempuan. Jadi, her house. Seperti itu ya. Nah, dia menunjukkan kepemilikan. Nah, bagaimana? Sudah paham belum antara pronoun, subjective pronoun ya maksudnya? Lalu kalian juga memahami tentang objective pronoun dan terakhir adalah possessive adjective. Jadi 3 hal itu dulu ya yang kita pelajari hari ini. Ada subject pronoun, lalu ada object pronoun dan possessive adjective. Semoga kalian paham ya sampai di sini. Sekarang kita akan kembali ke teks yang diberikan Hana tadi. So we are going to back to the text on page 4. After reading this text, I want you to do a reply letter. Jadi kalian menuliskan surat balasan kepada Hana. Imagine that you are Alia. Please tell Hana about yourself, your address, and then your hobbies, your families, your like, dislike, and also your dreams in the future. Contohnya, kalian bisa lihat di halaman 5 pada buku kalian. Kalau kalian punya pertanyaan, feel free to ask me. Well, segitu dulu ya pelajaran hari ini. I hope you understand. If you still don't, freely to ask me. Thank you for watching and do my task. See you!